Hollande, the humble president with 2% popularity in recent polls, will finally be leaving his chair to another candidate who could be either a populist anti-EU or a pro-EU globalist. The last request Hollande has for the French voters is to reject far-right candidate Marine Le Pen and back Emmanuel Macron to succeed him.
Emmanuel Macron aujourd'hui est celui qui défend les valeurs qui permettent le rassemblement des Français dans cette période si particulière, si grave, que connaît le monde, l'Europe et la France. Stop!
Worked as an advisor for previous President François Mitterrand, Hollande was cited as a potential presidential candidate, and on May 2012 he was elected president during the second round, voting with 51.7%.
ما فينا ننكر انه حاول كرئيس كتير يعدل من القرارات اللي اخذها ساركوزي هلا مثلا اشياء اللي بتتعلق بالتقاعد انه سن التقاعد اللي كان اخده ساركوزي انه اذا الواحد كمل عدد السنوات الخدمه في فل على 62 انه مش 60 سنه
استلم البلاد كانت عم بتعيش حاله انهيار اقتصادي وكان في إرث ورثه الرئيس هولاند إرث مليء بالمشاكل بدءا من البطالة إلى مشاكل الاندماج إلى يعني عدة مشاكل.
During his presidency, Hollande reformed labor laws and credit training programs, withdrew French combat troops present in the Afghanistan military intervention, concluded an EU directive through a Franco-German contract and led the country through a 2015 Paris terrorist attacks. He was a leading proponent of the NATO's 2011 military intervention in Libya and has sent troops to Mali and the Central African Republic.
Mais discuter, mais avec qui? Avec des terroristes qui se sont installés dans le Nord Mali, qui imposent une loi, la charia, et qui coupent des mains et qui détruisent des monuments jusque-là considérés comme au patrimoine de l'humanité. Discuter avec qui? Avec ACMI? Qui peut imaginer qu'il puisse y avoir là des conversations qui puissent être utiles?
Some of his actions and opinions regarding the EU mandatory migrant quote, the Saudi Arabian-led intervention in Yemen, Brexit and the proposed constitutional amendment regarding the removal of French citizenships from suspected terrorists have drawn domestic and international controversy.
يعني مثلا قصة انه الناس اللي بتطالب بمقاطعة اسرائيل صاروا يتحاكموا يعني اخذوهم للمحاكمة بس هيدا الشيء ما كان يعني حتى قصة الغاء الجنسية عن اللي بيرتكبوا اعمال او شيء بس هيدي كلياتها هالقرارات اللي ضد انه العرب بشكل عام مش هو اللي كان وراها اجمالا كان مانويل فالس ولهالسبب اساسا بتصور انه مانويل فالس خسر الانتخابات الداخليه بالحزب الاشتراكي
انه لاحظنا بالدوره الاولى كيف الشعب سجل انه رفض كلي الاحزاب التقليديه التي حكمت البلاد لخمسين سنه فمهما ترك يعني الشعب وصل لدرجة من التذمر والانتفاضة انه اختار يروح بغير طريق نحن رايحين على المجهول.
As a member of the G8, Hollande has struggled to revive the economy of France in ways that sparked long-term economic stimulus by increasing taxes and seeking unemployment up to 10% of December 2016.
بالنسبة لموضوع البطالة أولاً صحيح انه ارتفع عدد العمال يلي ما عم بيلاقوا شغل والبطاله ونحكى عن ملايين انه بخلال هالثلاث سنوات ولكن لاحظنا مؤخرا انه نشرت دراسات بلشت تعترف انه البطاله عم بتخف.
Concerning energy and development, Hollande has been a solid advocate for climate change awareness. By holding the Climate Change Summit in Paris 2015, which obligates states to take concrete measures to curb emissions that contribute to climate change in general. As for the Syrian crisis, French President François Hollande has repeated his support for action against the Assad regime, saying all necessary measures were being taken. He vowed to crush ISIS, the terrorist organization that launched suicide attacks in Paris in 2015, and called for a single coalition to fight it. which has won a swath of territories in Syria and Iraq.
Une honte pour la communauté internationale si nous n'y mettons pas fin rapidement. Alep est une ville aujourd'hui martyre, qui restera dans la mémoire des nations comme une ville martyre. Des milliers d'enfants sont écrasés sous les bombes. Des populations entières sont affamées. Des convois humanitaires sont attaqués. Des armes chimiques sont utilisées. Eh bien, je n'ai qu'un seul mot à dire. Ça suffit.
On December 1, 2016, he announced he would not seek re-election in the upcoming 2017 French presidential elections that will take place this coming May. In other news, clashes erupted at Paris rally today against Marie Le Pen, where three riot police officers were hurt in the clashes between the masked youth and the police this afternoon. This is Farah Al-Hashim reporting for KTVT News, Paris.